It's a really common requirement to be able to filter tables of data via the keywords within it, via a search or something like this. You can custom code something in Rails, but I'm a fan of using the Ransack gem. So let's jump in. We're going to start by adding the Ransack gem to our app. So I'm going to do bundle add Ransack. Cool. And on the controller for this page, I'm going to scroll down here a little bit. I'm going to add something very similar to this onto it. So I'm going to start by adding a variable called Q, and that stands for like query. And we're going to type our model name and then the ransack method, which that gem has added. And because it looks for the URL bar params, which will start with Q, we're just going to pass in params and then the Q symbol. And then for our actual posts, we can just do result. And that's going to return the result of the ransack query, so all the attributes which match. So it says undefined method ransack. This is because I didn't restart Rails. That's cool. And yeah, we're still showing the same list as before. So we need a way to filter these. Ransack actually comes with a little form helper we can use to do this. So I'm just going to take their sample straight out the docs, go to my index page here, and let's do your end. Okay, read that comment, and I don't have a name field, so I'm just going to change that to be name contains or underscore cont. And this is going to say, okay, if the title field contains any of these, only return that. So let's actually see it in action. So you can see we've got that. I totally forgot to put a way to submit the form in there. Submit. There we go. Okay, so let's have a look for IPA. Okay, that's quite cool. It's just filtered all the ones which contain the term IPA. That's really nice. Okay, what if we wanted to filter based on if this field is present? If we quickly jump to their docs, they've actually got a really nice table. Here it is, with the search matches, where they've got all the things you can end the field name with. So if I was to do like not null, I could be like, okay, return all the fields where this field is not null. So I can actually put this into the URL, but if I really wanted to, so I could do NQ, let's call it published at equals one. Okay, so let's just turn that into a checkbox field. So do this again. I'll quickly put that there. I'm going to do published. I'm going to call it not null. And not null there as well. And see what that looks like. Okay. That doesn't look so great. Let's make this a checkbox. There we go. So if I was to uncheck it, check it. Okay, that's kind of close. Let's kind of change this label quickly. Published. That's nice. It'd be nice if it was unchecked, it showed everything though. Only show published. The way we're going to do that is by changing what the checkbox is outputting behind the scenes. You can see like right now we have a hidden field where if it's not checked, it'll fall back to the value of 0. Otherwise it does 1. So if we were to do, I think it's 1 and 0. So this is the value when it's checked. This is the value when it's not checked. Have a look what that does. Cool. So if it's not checked, it'll just not send that field. Does that work? Yeah. I don't like how we have this commit equals search in the URL bar there. This actually comes from this submit button having name equals commit. If I was to make that blank and then click search, it would actually be blank. So what I want to do is in my form here, if I was to do like name equals blank, that'll probably stay blank between page loads. Let's have a look. Yeah, it does. And it works as well. That's awesome. Sometimes you might want to limit the fields you allow Ransack to publicly search. So for example, if you've got a field called like body and maybe you want to not let people search on that field. So in this case, I have a field called body and yeah, it's got various text and I might not want people to be able to search that for whatever reason. Ransack gives you a way to say, okay, only search these fields. And what it is on the post or on your model, whatever one you've added it to, you're going to get this method called ransackable attributes. So what we're going to do is just limit that to only return the fields we want. So let's go to our model and I'm going to do def self.ransackableattributes, and there is a method which I think gets passed in here. I can't remember what it is though, so we'll come back to that in a sec when it raises an error. And we're just going to limit this to these fields here. Well, actually, no, let's see what the title one published at. All right, let's see what error this raises. Okay, so it says wrong arguments given one, so I think it's auth objects equals nil. There we go. So as you can see now, it is not actually honoring the search for that field. But if I was to do like title and IPA, it will just filter the IPA stuff. They have a few other methods you can override under the authorization section of the Ransack repo. This is for things like the associations and scopes and stuff like that. Hopefully that gives you a nice introduction as to what Ransack is and how you can use it. The actual documentation has like a lot more to it. Like you can search on multiple fields using the same input, and you can also search on like has many and belongs to relationships as well. For the same thing, which is really cool. Hopefully this just gave you a nice insight and you'll be curious enough to have a play with it. If you want me to do a little bit more on Ransack, please remember to smash that like button and let me know in the comments section below.